Okay, well, I thought I was finished, but Spirit said no. That's also a very good point. Spirit will give you directives. Intuition will lead you and guide you in such a gentle way. You know, yesterday I was looking for a washing machine, and I had been saving money for a while. I couldn't afford to buy a brand new one, so I, you know, was looking around at some used appliance stores, and I had put aside $200 for another washing machine, and I had two places written down that I got offline that I would go to, and on my way, after I had left my third place, I was on my way to my fourth place, and I was giving up. I was on my way home, and when I was driving down the street, I saw this Maytag appliance store, and I remember seeing it on the way up the road, but I thought to myself, oh, gee, you know, that place is going to be really expensive. I stopped there, however, and as soon as I walked in the back room where they had their used appliances, I saw my stove, you know, and I was able to get it and have it delivered just at 2:17, you know. And so, you know, I was in my car before I started my journey, and I said, I don't like to waste time, and I've always done this when I was looking for jobs or anything. Okay, you know what I'm looking for. You know where it is. Please help me to get to it in the optimal amount of time. Now, if I had went there when I first saw the store and my first inclination, but it was on the other side of a four-lane road, so my inclination naturally was to go to the place that I was going, which was just about 5 or 7 minutes up the road, and go there on my way back. So I was obedient, and because I was obedient, I received my blessing. When you're not used to listening to intuition, you can miss it so many times. Have you ever found yourself saying, oh man, I should have listened to myself? Oh man, I knew something was trying to tell me not to do it, and you are kicking yourself. Why did I do that thing? You know, I have been there so many times in the past, but I can honestly say that I haven't really in a very long time, because I've been a good listener. In order to be a good listener, you have to get in harmony with silence. In order to hear anything, you have to block out everything else. And silence is a good portion of my life. So I don't like to have a lot of noise in my life, because I'm always receiving information. First of all, I'm very empathic, I'm very sensitive, you know, to energies, not only in people, but in things. But in general, if you want to learn to listen to your inner voices, you need to have quiet as much as possible. So, for instance, if the first thing you do in the morning is turn on your television, I like to encourage you not to do that. When you get up in the morning, and you open your eyes and just look around your room. Spend some time in gratitude, you know, and being grateful for everything that you have to bed you're laying on, everything around you. I always try and listen to the birds if I hear any birds. I listen to see if it's raining, or I live in Seattle area, so, you know. And whether or not the sun is shining. And then I talk to God. You know, I talk to my creator. That's the first thing I always do. Now, if I end up getting interrupted by the telephone, or, you know, have to use the bathroom, I will get back in my bed, because I won't miss that time. That's the most wonderful way to start your day. You know, so you're positioning yourself to listen. Okay, you're positioning and teaching yourself how to be silent and how to listen. And when you learn how to listen, you will learn the difference between your voice. You will learn the difference between the voice of intuition. And you will learn the difference between the voice of spirit. And like I said, spirit will give directives. Intuition will give directives too. And like I said, intuition is a function of spirit. Just as my voice is the function of my body. Okay, so when you learn to ask it questions and you practice in little ways, that's how you will be training yourself to know what its voice sounds like. Now, it's going to take some time, you know, if you've never done this before, if you don't have any experience at all, but I promise you it will be fun. You know, ask intuition, ask spirit anything, and it will lead you. If you can't find your car keys, say out loud. You can practice saying it silently too, because it's all about experiencing and it's fun. Ask, where are your car keys? I have a lot of books, and sometimes I want to reference a certain one and I don't know where I put it. And man, I'll tell you, there was one time I was looking for this book for 3 days, and you know what? I looked in the same spot in the same bookshelf. The fault was not intuition. The fault was mine, because that book was there. But see, the problem is that on my bookshelf, I have so many books that I have some that are sitting up straight and I have some that are lying down. And the book that I was looking for was actually underneath the bigger one. And so then finally, on the third day, I noticed there was a space. And I stuck my hand under there and there was the book. You know, and I was so grateful that I found that book, because I was beginning to wonder, you know, if my philosophy was failing me. You know, but it wasn't, you know. So the error is always in us, not in intuition, because intuition will never fail you, okay? And so take some time, listen, and practice, and have fun with it, you know. If you're looking for something and you know how much money you can afford to pay for it, if you're... if you just want to know, you know, about the character of a person, if that person is good for you, ask. You know, is this someone that I should associate with? If there is something that you want to do in your life and you have maybe 2 or 3 projects pending, ask which one to do first. You know what I'm saying? Ask which way to walk when you're just taking a walk. You never know who you're going to run into. You never know what you're going to be for somebody on a given day. I ask even, and this is how this whole thing started, I ask when I'm sending out comments on MySpace, here, you know, for the right comment to be sent. I don't believe in wasting words. I know that words are energy. I know that words create things, that words are things, you know, and so then when I do use words, I'm very careful. And when I send them to who I will, I'm always allowing myself to be led by spirit. So if you get a comment from me, and you're wondering about it, know that it didn't come from me. Sometimes I've had people get mad at me, you know, and it might just be a simple affirmation of truth, you know, that I left, but because they felt convicted or afraid, because they felt like I knew something about them that I shouldn't have, you know. And most people receive it, you know, in the manner that it was given. And the only reason why spirit has to use people like me is because you haven't learned to listen to your own voice yet. Okay, and when you learn to listen to your own voice, you won't have to depend on anybody. You won't have to depend on anything, you know, for your guidance and your direction. You depend on that inner voice, on that spirit that is in you. Because it is in each and every one of us. The more you use it, the more it will be developed in you. And before you know it, you'll be living the thing. You won't have to seek spirit. It will exude from you. You won't have to seek wisdom. It will exude from you. And then you'll notice that things will start showing up in your life before you even ask. And then it really begins to get fun. Peace and blessings. So much love I have that I'm sending out to you. And make it a good day.